So let's also have a look at this example, which is very similar, but it's a different kind of size. So here we have a 4x3 matrix E. We're still asked to find a basis for the kernel and its nullity. So now we're interested in still solving the equation EX equals 0, but now X is a vector with 3 components, because that's the only way you can multiply sensibly. So X will be a vector of the form X1, X2, X3. And the picture that you should have in mind is that now what we're doing is we're taking a vector in three-dimensional space and we're multiplying it by E to give us a vector in four-dimensional space. Perhaps here. So this is E times X. And again, we're interested in vectors over here which get sent to zero. Maybe it's a line, say. Sake of argument, might be a line of vectors, the kernel of E, those vectors in three-dimensional space that get sent to zero under this transformation. So it's this equation which is still the crucial thing that we have to do. We have to row reduce the matrix and solve the system EX equals zero. Okay, so what happens? Well, we're going to row reduce, so we'll take row 2 equals row 2 minus 2 times row 1. Row 3 equals row 3 minus 5 times row 1. That will give us 1, 1, minus 1. This minus 2 times that, minus 3, 2. This minus 5 times that. This minus 5 times that, minus 9. This minus 5 times that, 6. And this just stays where it is. Okay, and then we can take row 3 equals row 3 minus 3 times row 2. That will give us 1, 1, minus 1, 0, minus 3, 2. So it's basically this is a multiple of that one, so we're going to get a row of zeros, and then we get 0, 0, 1. And we can go over here, we can interchange row 3 and row 4. And we can also multiply row 3, row 2, by multiplying it by minus a third. That'll give us 1, 1, minus 1, 0, 1, minus 2 thirds, 0, 0, 1, and the row of zeros is now at the bottom. Okay, so we've arranged that our pivot entries are staggered down to the right. The rows of zeros are all at the bottom. So we can read off from here what the situation is in terms of solutions. Okay, each one of these columns is a pivot column, so there's a unique solution. A unique solution, since every column in the D part of the matrix on the left-hand side of the adjacency matrix is a pivot column. And that means, therefore, that the original equation EX equals zero has only the solution X equals the zero vector. That's the solution, it's the only solution, and that's telling us that if we go back to this diagram, the actual situation is that the kernel looks like just the point. Okay, so there's the actual kernel of E, and therefore the nullity is zero.